Welcome to the Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis Show on the Colgate Comedy Hour, brought to you by the Colgate Palmolive Company, makers of Colgate Dental Cream, Fab, Ajax Cleanser, Palmolive Rapid Shave, and Vito. I am your host for this evening, Jim Selman, and we'd like to present the finest in entertainment. The Colgate Palmolive Company takes great time and effort in presenting as much dignity as they can possibly muster. We feel that good taste and the finer type of entertainment is the uppermost important thing. And so, with this thinking in mind, we would like to take this opportunity to introduce a great guest, a gentleman who is a great world traveler, adventurer, and one of the most magnificent news correspondents of our time. Ladies and gentlemen, we're proud to present Mr. Tedward R. Burrow.
Oh, there you are. Good evening. This is Tedward R. Burrow, bringing you Person to People. And tonight we travel all the way to Hollywood through the wonders of television, where we are going to visit with a famous motion picture personality. And this is the palatial home in which he lives, high in the Hollywood Hills, nestled among the residences of other motion picture luminaries or luminaries, I don't know how it's said, a border of well-kept shrubs and trees line the winding road that leads up to the home of our distinguished guest. May we come in? Harlan Sando, may we come in?
You sure can't come in. I'm very glad to have you in my house, Mr. Bow. I'm very, very glad. I'm glad to have you here in my house. I'm glad you came to visit me here in my house. How you feel, Mr. Bow?
I feel all right, Harlan. Say, Harlan, isn't that a motorcycle that you're sitting... a motorcycle? You're sitting on a motorcycle. That is a motorcycle, isn't it? You're sitting on a motorcycle there, aren't you?
That's right, Mr. Burrow. It's a motorcycle. This is a motorcycle.
You like that?
Yeah, motorcycle's my hobby.
Oh, yeah, motorcycling?
Oh, no, sitting.
Sitting.
I just like to sit, that's all, Mr. Burrow.
Well, tell me, what are all those contractions on the handlebars there? What are all those?
That's a very good question, Mr. Burrow. That's a real good question. You know, a lot of people ask me stupid questions all the time. Silly questions like, how's everything? How you feel? Well, but your question is different. And it's interesting. And it's truly controversial. And I'm going to answer that question. Yeah. This thing is a horn right here. Yeah, I blow that to avoid running over people.
Harden, aren't those other things, aren't those things you have there, bongo drums?
That's right. I do this to avoid running over mumbo dancers.
Hey, Harlan, those bongo drums, really, they fascinate me. They're bongo drums, aren't they?
Oh, yeah, that's right. They're real cute little things, too, bongo drums. And you know where these bongo drums come from, Mr. Burrow?
I don't have the faintest idea.
Well, these drums come from an animal.
An animal?
Yeah, and these drums are very hard to get, too, you see. Mr. Burrow, you sneak up on this animal in the jungle, and when his back is turned,
yeah,
you steal his bongos.
When he isn't looking, Harlan.
When he's not looking. You can't steal him if he's looking.
Well, you really play those bongos. You play those bongo drums, don't you? Gosh.
You're a happy fella, ain't you, Mr. Bob? Yeah, I only play these bongo drums to accompany myself when I sing.
Oh, do you sing?
Do I sing? That's a good question. As a matter of fact, that question makes a bum out of your first question. It's a real good question. Yeah, I sing, and the only way I can answer it is by singing, Mr. Burrow. Listen to this. Come on along.
That
it was
like
a little flat. I think I got a sick bungle.
Yeah. Yeah, that's fine. You know, I see something very interesting on your mantelpiece. Is it what I think it is?
Oh, yeah. These are my treasured possessions, Mr. Burrow. Right over here is a resistor plug. And it's based on a vacuum hiding frequency of when you go uphill or downhill on a motorcycle, it cuts the chassis lubrication down and causes you to go downhill, and it's best to ride that way on the rim so you don't waste the rubber.
And what about the other interesting item there?
Oh, well, this is a combination vacillator, and you use this in order to gain speed and pick up momentum so that you can use this at the same time, save fuel.
Fuel?
That's right. You use this to save fuel.
Well, say, Harlan, isn't that Oscar over there?
No, I'm here by myself in the house.
No, I mean, what is that? No, I mean, between the register plug and the carbonation equalizer, isn't that an Oscar?
Oh, yeah, that's right. They gave that to me.
Oh, for what?
For making a picture.
Oh, well, what picture?
Boy, this guy is terrific. Did you say what picture?
Yes, for what picture did you get the Oscar?
How do I know? I never go to the movie.
Don't go. Harlan?
Uh-huh.
Our time is getting rather short. May we meet the members of your family?
Members of my family? Well, this is a resistor plug, and this is a carbon dioxide.
No, no. How about your family, Harlan?
Oh, you mean people? Yeah, I'd like you to meet my twin sisters right over here. This is my twin sister. This is Molly. She's 6 years old. And this is Maud. She's 24.
Well, let's hold it right there, Harlan. Hold it. Now, if one is 6 and the other is 24, how can they be twins?
I'll be a son of a gun. You asked the best question I know. I couldn't give it. If she's 6 and she's 24, how can they be twins? Well, I can answer that one. You see, she's my half-sister. And this one lies about her age.
Oh, that's real fine. Say, Harlan, I'm afraid we'll have to bring this little visit to a close. Our time is just about up.
Well, just a bit, Mr. Burrow. You know, you always come into people's houses and you ask them personal questions and all things like that. And it's a wonderful show you got, Person to People. But we'd like to know, maybe, how about getting a look at your family once?
Well, all right, Harlan. I'd like you to meet my family.
I brush my teeth 3 times a day.
I brush my teeth twice a day.
I brush my teeth only once a day.
Even if you brush your teeth only once a day, Colgate Dental Cream gives the surest protection all day long. Brushing for brushing, the surest protection ever offered by any toothpaste. Because only Colgate's of all leading toothpastes contains Gardol. Here's how Gardol works. What kept these pins from being hit? This invisible protective shield. Now, every time you use Colgate's Gardol binds itself to your teeth, forming another kind of invisible protective shield that won't rinse off or wear off all day. Every time you use new Colgate, it stops unpleasing breath instantly. Fights tooth decay 12 hours or more. Tests showed the greatest reduction in tooth decay in toothpaste history. So brush your teeth as often as your dentist tells you. But remember, even if you brush your teeth only once a day, Colgate Dental Cream gives the surest protection all day long.
Wow! Nobody gets clothes as dirty as a backyard Indian. And no other kind of product gets dirty clothes as clean and white as Fab.
There's more active dirt remover in Fab, Fab, Fab. Yes, there's more active dirt remover in great new Fab. Fab has more active dirt remover than any other leading product.
Fab washes really white and clean.
The whitest white and cleanest clean.
Get F-A-B Fab.
Yes, Fab, with more active dirt remover, washes clothes really clean, really white. No other product gives you so much active dirt remover. Plus two such fabulous whitening ingredients, clothes need no bluing, no bleaching except for stubborn stains. Fab washes clothes the whitest white and cleanest clean. Yet Fab is milder to hands than even leading floating soaps.
Fab washes really white and clean.
The whitest white and cleanest clean. Get F-A-B Fab.
With more active dirt remover than any other leading product.
Good evening, Mr. and Mrs. Martin.
Well, evening, hi. Oh, I see dinner's all ready.
Yes, madam, exactly the way you planned it. Happy anniversary.
Thank you, John. Now, would you mind hanging up the clothes, please?
Not at all, Mr. Martin.
Oh, it's all right, sir.
Darling, isn't it wonderful, just think. You and I are going to be alone here at the beach house.
This is going to be real wonderful. Just you and I all together by ourselves, a whole week just together, you know that?
Oh, it's wonderful, darling, at last. Honey, I'm not complaining, but it isn't easy being married to a movie star.
Look, this is going to be our second honeymoon, honey. Everything just the way you want it. Your favorite flowers, favorite dish, veal scallopini and matzo balls. Intermarriage. Listen, and your favorite champagne. This is a Champs-Élysées Chablis. Yeah, the English translation, Manischewitz, 1945. That was his best year. That's when he left his wife.
Oh, honey, I'm going upstairs and try.
All righty. I'll get us a drink. How about that? Yeah, there's nothing like a little drink, you know, to help. I'll have it ready for you in a second, sweetheart. Oh, boy. Nothing like a scotch with a scotch chaser, I always say. Oh, come in. Hey, Bruce, what is this?
The kid's in town. He's waiting outside.
What kid? What town?
The kid who won the Hollywood contest. You know, I told you about it.
You didn't tell me nothing.
Oh, yes, I did. It's a publicity stunt for your new picture. The kid outside's the winner. Gets a free trip to Hollywood, gets a test for a part in your new picture, and a week's stay with his favorite movie star who happens to be you.
Don't you understand that this happens to be my wife and our second honeymoon?
Good. I'll call
her. Now, what? Go on. Kid?
He talked to me, D. Martin. I'll never wash my ear. He talked to me. D. Martin talked to me. And me in the same room with him. Did you see him say to me, how are you, kid?
All right, kid. All right. Well, what seems to be there? What's on your mind? Are you here?
You look just like you do on a silver screen. I'm so thrilled to death I can't even hear my heart palpitating for a second. You look like you do on a silver screen with the hair coiled and the nice suit and everything. Let me see if it's true.
What is that?
The Photoplay magazine said you had a mole on your right knee. It's a lie.
I had it removed.
Can I have it? Where's the mole?
All right, come on, I will take some pictures. Sit down, Mr. Martin. Will you please sit down?
Oh, yeah. Oh, take pictures. All right. Why didn't I smile when they took me?
So, you're the kid that won the contest, huh?
Yeah, I'm so excited, I can't even
stand. Well, what's your name?
Georgie.
Georgie.
My name is Georgie Hillman.
Georgie Hillman?
Yeah, and I'm awful glad to be with you here this close, Mr. Martin.
Mm-hmm. Don't go. You call me Dean.
Call him Dean by his first name. Call him Dean by his first name. By his first name, call him Dean. I heard him say by his first name. First name.
Please don't faint. We're running out of scotch.
I'll make it better.
There goes the suede. Look.
I'm sorry, Mr. Martin, but I'm so excited to be here in your house.
That's all right. Listen, is there anything you'd like, you know?
Well, the only thing I'd like to be here with you all the time. Maybe you'll give me an autograph so I could have it to take home.
Oh, get it.
Yeah, just sign. Here, Mr. Martin, just sign my autograph book, would you please? Here's the pen. I'm so excited. I never thought I'd live to see this day. Here, right down to Georgie.
To Georgie?
It's swell to meet you, Georgie. And, oh, what a swell fellow you are. We will be pals.
Hold it, I'll go.
We will always be friends together. You and me, Georgie.
Yeah, you'll need another book for this.
I have refills. Yeah. Really, it's swell to know you and to think that we can go together and be friends.
All right.
P.S. Why didn't I meet you before, dear Georgie?
All right. There, now that will do it for you.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Martin. I'm really thrilled to death. I want to show you this, Mr. Martin. Look at this. I got my scrapbook and my book here. You want to see it?
Well, not necessarily.
All right, here it is. It's my What Dean Martin Doesn't Use scrapbook. It's really terrific. Look, let me show you here. Remember when you got into the movies, Mr. Martin?
Yeah.
And you went to the barber shop and they shaved off your mustache?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I have it here, see? My mother made a tie clip out of it.
Tie clip out of it, sure. Yeah. Well, when I raise another mustache, maybe she'll make me some cufflinks to go with it.
Yeah, it'll be a set.
A set, sure.
And do you remember, Mr. Martin, when you were walking on Broadway in 1947? You were walking on Broadway, you were eating an O. Henry bar.
Oh, that was on 54th Street.
I'll be a son of a gun with a memory to die. Anyhow, you threw away that half O. Henry bar, do you remember? And I picked it up. I've been saving it ever since.
You saved it?
It melted. My favorite souvenir melted. Maybe you can eat me another souvenir?
I'm not a souvenir eater.
Oh, I'm awful sorry because I'm eating it like that. Could I have another souvenir, Mr. Martin? Could you let me have another souvenir?
Well, I could probably let you
maybe
have
a button. Could I have a button?
Yeah, I'll get
let me
I'll
take
get
this
a button.
Button.
Hey!
That'd be nice for my souvenir
well,
book.
Well, look what you did to my suit.
Well, what are you worried about? The magazine, Photoplay magazine, always says you got thousands of suits.
Yeah, but they're all against me. Look at it. Listen now, Georgie.
You're going to change your
jacket? I got to change my jacket, and you answer the phone.
Oh, all right. I'll be glad to. The phone didn't ring yet.
Well, why wait till the last minute?
Why wait till the last minute? That makes sense, I guess so. The son of a gun, how he knows just what's going to happen. Hello, this is Mr. Martin's residence. Who would you like to speak to? Mr. Martin? Oh, well, who's calling, please? He's a movie star. He has to... Who? Gary Cooper. All right, just a minute, Mr. Gary Cooper.
Gary. Hiya, Gary. No, I was just an idiot. No, that's all right. Yeah. Well, you learned how to say nope? Good.
Good for you.
Don't lose that yep, though. All right. Well, we'll see you at Bel Air tomorrow. So long.
Gary Cooper. Was really Gary Cooper on the telephone?
Yeah, it wasn't Sam Fuller.
Oh, it was really Gary Cooper.
Yeah.
Gary Cooper and D. Martin spoke on the same telephone. What a souvenir this will be. What a souvenir for my book.
Don't say that. Oh.
Too late. You're a souvenir.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't know we had company.
Sweetheart, this is not company. This happens to be Georgie. Georgie, this is my wife.
Mrs. Martin, what a souvenir! What a terrific souvenir!
No, you don't close it up like that.
Why, will she melt?
Yes, she'll melt.
I'm awful glad to meet you, Mrs. Martin. I'm really thrilled to meet you. You and him are together, both married. What a thrill. Will you give me an autograph, Mrs. Martin? Please just give me an autograph. Your husband gave it to me right down here. Just pick any page that's empty. I'll open the pen right down to Georgie.
Oh, why don't you it's stop well with meeting. That whole thing? It's well meeting. You did that with me now. Oh,
well, I'm awful sorry. I just wanted
Who
to
Who is he?
Autograph.
He happened to be the boy that won the contest. How did you win this contest, Georgie?
Oh, well, you see, Mr. Martin, Mrs. Martin, I won the contest to come out here to Hollywood, California by singing Davy Crockett three ways. Yeah, frontwards, sidewards, and backwards.
Yeah, would you mind showing us how you did it?
Yeah, I'll be glad to. First, backwards. Frontier wild, Crockett Davy, oh, king of Wally. Now I'll sing it for you. Now I'll sing it for you. Sideways.
Sideways, that'd be good.
Rocket, no me, no, 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 see, la, la, no, melon, call it day.
Are you going to sing it frontward now?
I'll sing it frontward, sideways, and backwards with hopping.
With hopping, that's it.
Some and nail, no, no, melon, no, no, call it day, no, bum, bum, a day, no, crack it, day, muck away.
All through?
No, I'm not finished yet. Home and Maiden.
Home and Maiden. Listen now. Now, look, is there anything else that you'd like to do? I mean,
Well, not really. I would just like to stay here with you and all that. I'd appreciate it very much because I enjoy...
Do you sing anything else? Do you do any other things?
Well, I do a lot of things. I don't have too much talent, but I can make up songs if you want to hear that. I can make up songs from any words you say. You
make
know,
them
I,
up?
I, yeah, oh, yeah, I sit sometimes at parties for hours. All you have to do is
well,
say
well,
something.
Well, look, kid.
Try me. You just say anything and I'll make up a song.
Look, kid, not now.
Not now.
Not now.
A little later.
Oh, fine.
Oh, stop.
Oh,
fine. Oh, stop.
Oh, brother.
Oh, fine. Oh, stop. Oh, brother. Oh, songs are made and come and go. I never had a note.
All right. We'll have that published for you.
Thank you very much. I'd appreciate
right.
it. Thank
it's
you, Mr. Martin.
Look, don't you understand? Now, you got the autographs. You showed us everything. Why don't you leave it? This is our second honeymoon. We want to be alone.
Oh, it's your anniversary.
That's what it is,
You
yeah.
together both yet after
sure.
so many years,
That's
too?
That's right. Uh-huh.
That's wonderful. But uh-huh. you don't understand, Mr. Martin. I don't want to be in your way or anything like that. But you see, according to the contest, it clearly states that if I win the
I
contest...
I know what the contest clearly states.
Oh?
I know it is. It's an all-expensive trip to Hollywood. You stay a week at my house. And you get a part in my next picture.
That's right. I'm glad you know the rules. You have to remember them. I get an all-expense trip to Hollywood. A week stay at your house. And a part in your new picture. I didn't hear nothing. How come you said it? You got music.
Orchestra leader's Italian.
Mr. Martin.
Yes?
Your bags are unpacked, sir.
Oh, they are?
Yes, sir.
Well, thank
Look
you.
At this They're... Dean Martin's butler. The man that butlers Dean Martin. What a souvenir he made.
Ah, sweetheart, I'm sorry. That's what the contest says. He's got to stay a whole week.
A whole week? What about our honeymoon?
I have a little idea. Look, we'll give him that phony screen test. He can't possibly memorize all those words, and he'll get so disillusioned, he'll go home.
Yeah.
We'll try that, huh? Little screen test.
Look at this souvenir I got. He was very, very cooperative, this butler here. I'm going to enjoy
Georgie.
Having that with the old Henry Bob.
Come here.
Yes,
sir. The contest said if you won, you would get a screen test, right?
Yeah, screen test.
All right, well, you're going to get it.
I'm going to get it. Let's go to the studio.
No, hold it, Georgie. You're going to do it right here, the screen test.
Here in this place?
Yes. John, would you bring the script from the suitcase, please?
Gee, will it be a musical? Can I do my musical number? Tell me name. Oh, no, I'm not well.
It's all drama.
Oh, drama. It'll be nice for the summer if he wears that. It's cool.
Shoelaces were untied. Listen, now look, kid. Now, you got to be able to memorize the dialogue the first time you hear it. You understand?
The first time I hear it, I got to memorize the dialogue.
Yeah, or else you don't get the part and you have to go home.
All right, okay? I'll listen to it. I'll memorize the first time I hear it.
Now, this is the part you have to memorize, see? You come in and you say, good evening, Mr. Pendergrass. I realize this is an invasion of your privacy, but there's something of vital import which I must discuss with you. True, I am but a lowly mill hand, not in the same social sphere as your illustrious daughter who has had the benefit of governesses, French tutors, and finishing schools, but I shall rise above my humble beginnings, even though I am the son of a lowly harness and saddle maker. And as the eminent philosopher and historian Albert Schweitzer so aptly put it, the result of the voyage does not depend on the speed of the ship, whether it be a fast sailor or somewhat slower, nor on the method of propulsion, whether by sails or by steam, but on whether or not it keeps a true course and whether or not its steering gear remains in order. Now, you learn this.
You want me to memorize it the first time?
First time.
All right. I'll go out and try it.
Right. Honey, he can't possibly do it. I couldn't do it reading it.
Wait till I knock.
All right. Here we go.
Good evening, Mr. Pendergrass. I realize this is an invasion of your privacy, but there's something of vital import which I must discuss with you. True, I am but a lowly mill hand. A lowly mill hand I am, not in the same social sphere as your illustrious daughter, who has had the benefit of governesses, French tutors, and finishing schools, but I shall rise above my humble beginnings, even though I am the son of a lowly harness and saddle maker. And I, as the eminent philosopher and historian Albert Schweitzer once said, feel the result of the voyage does not depend upon the speed of the ship, whether it be a first sailor or somewhat slower, nor on the method of propulsion, whether by sails or by steam, but on whether or not it's a keep true of course, and whether or not its steering gear remains in order.
How did you remember all that?
I used to be an elephant.
Oh, stop. Yes, darling.
The house guest. I'll go fix this room.
All right, sweetheart.
I'm glad I'm going to stay. Thank you, Mrs. Martin, very much. Thank you, Mr. Martin. You see, the only reason I like to stay is because you're my favorite movie star. I see you in the movies and all, on the television and all that. And I like you when I see you, and I thought maybe
Would
I could
you
be...
like to be in movies?
Well, I thought if I could ever be a movie star, I'd be swell, but I'm not handsome, and I don't have a lot of talent.
Oh, you needn't be handsome and have a lot of talent, old boy.
No.
No, just sit down. Let me tell you. You know, you got to have something. You know what you got to have?
No, what is that?
You gotta have heart.
When your sink looks dark and greasy, clean it quick and bright and easy with the foaming action cleanser.
Use Ajax! Boom, boom.
Only Ajax with foaming action.
Clean so quick!
Polishes so bright!
And works so easy.
Use Ajax, boom, boom. The foaming cleanser. Boom, 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 boom. Cleans your sink. Just like a whiz.
Ajax cuts grease faster than any other leading cleanser.
You'll stop paying the elbow tax when you start cleaning with Ajax. So use Ajax, the foaming cleanser. Floats the dirt right down the drain.
Ajax leaves no gritty cleanser scum. Ajax is quick.
Right.
And easy.
And Ajax smells good, too.
So use Ajax.
Thank you very much. It was a big kick for Dean and I to see our film on our TV show for the first time. We're proud to present a guest, ladies and gentlemen. We've tried to secure the finest in entertainment throughout the world. We feel we have a champ, a real champion, the world's greatest drummer, Mr. Buddy Rich himself. Ladies and gentlemen, let's take a moment. Buddy,
yes.
We're real thrilled to have you on our show, and all of us, the crew, Dean and myself, everybody, we can't wait to hear you play the great drums.
Let's go to it.
All right, do you have your drums with you?
Oh, sure.
On you?
No, not on me. They're out in the back there someplace.
Oh, well, can we have Mr. Rich's drums so that we can hear him play the real great... Oh, boy, there they are. Hey, I'm real excited myself, buddy, because I love the way you play.
You ready to play?
But before you play, could I play something with you? Because I have a set here, too.
I'd like to play with Mr. Rich, if you don't mind.
helpful on this show here. All right, now, buddy. Get prepared to meet your master.
I'm ready.
You were really ready, weren't you? It's very embarrassing, this whole thing. You get an A. Splendid. All right. I followed you.
Right.
Right. No, you followed me. Now I'll follow you.
Follow me. Ready?
Right. Splendid, buddy, but let me show you what you did wrong.
Thank you.
shave, I'll shave them all. Rapid shave, I'll shave them all. No messy brush, no greasy cream. Use rapid shave in the morning.
All you do is press the top. Instant lather on the spot. Easy on with fingertips. See how fast your razor zips.
Palmolive Rapid Shave outshaves any lather or brushless cream. Palmolive Rapid Shave outshaves them all. Rapid Shave is faster. Instant lather at your fingertips. Rapid Shave saves time. Rapid Shave is smoother. No scrape, no pull, no ouch. Rapid Shave saves face. Rapid Shave is cleaner. Rinses instantly. Not messy like lather, not greasy like brushless cream. Rapid Shave saves trouble. Palmolive Rapid Shave costs only 79 cents. Nearly 3 months' supply of instant lather.
Rapid Shave, I'll shave them all. Rapid Shave, I'll shave them all. No messy brush, no greasy cream. Use Rapid Shave in the morning.
Get Palmolive Rapid Shave. It outshaves them all.
Thank you. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. We hope you enjoyed the show, because we enjoyed doing it for you. And don't forget the Colgate Variety Hour starting Sunday, June 12th. And the host will be Mr. Charlton Heston, star of Paramount's Far Horizon. And the stars of the first show will be Jimmy Stewart, June Ellison, Sarah Vaughan. First TV appearance, Miss Vera Allen. Ladies and gentlemen, and thanks again to Sonny King for flying out here. Jerry, take it away.
Yes, Sonny came to us by way of the Copacabana through Julie Fidel, and we appreciate it. We want to thank Buddy Rich, a great performer. And we want to thank the Firemen of America, ladies and gentlemen, who did such a great job for the Muscular Dystrophy Association last year and who have accepted to do it again this year. We thank you, Firemen. We want to say on behalf of Dean and myself, we hope you'll see our new picture, You're Never Too Young. And until we see you again, the show is over, folks.
Right,
you might as well go home. That's
get
it. Everybody up. Show's over. Out. Leave your seat. Out. Everybody out. Out.
Thank you.
Look at the applause.